Hello, everyone. My name is Yuan Karpanen, and I'm a program manager on Microsoft Azure Active Directory team focusing on group management. Today, I'm very excited to be here to explain group functionalities and how your organization can leverage the latest features of Azure Active Directory groups for your own group management. A group, as suggested by its name, is a collection of directory objects, such as users, devices, groups, and other service principles. Organizations use groups for collaboration and securing access. On Azure Active Directory, customers can create and manage two types of groups: security groups and Office 365 groups. Security groups are used to control user access to resources. Azure AD helps you give access to your organization's resources by providing access rights to a single user or to an entire Azure AD group. Using groups allows the resource owner to assign access permissions to all the members of the group, instead of having to provide the rights one by one. Security groups can have users and other object types as members. The power of Office 365 groups is in collaboration, perfect for people who work together on a project or a team. They are created with resources that members of the group can share, including an Outlook mailbox, a calendar, a SharePoint document library, a planner, Power BI, Yammer, or a team. Adding members to the group automatically gives them the permissions to the tools that the group provides. Now that we have gone through the basic group types, let's take a look at how groups can be created and managed on Azure Active Directory. A group can be created on multiple places: on Azure Portal, on My Groups End User Portal, Microsoft Graph, and AAD PowerShell. Let's take Azure Portal, for example. During creation, you can also assign owners and members to the group. Group type is selected at creation time, and it can't be changed once a group is created. Same with the group object ID. From the Members tab, you can add members or delete members from the group. Similar operations can be performed with Group Owner tab. From Group Membership tab, you can see which groups this group is a member of. Of course, from Application, Licenses, Azure Resources, you can manage access of application and resources and license assignment to this group, so members of the group can get access. Once a group is not needed anymore, you can delete the group. Please note that you can restore Office 365 groups within 30 days after deletion. The group, along with group memberships, will be restored. When deleting a security group, please make sure the group, app, and resource assignment of the group is no longer needed, because security group cannot be restored at the moment. Now we have walked through basic group types and group operations. Thank you for watching. In our next episode, we will go over more advanced group features, such as group expiration, dynamic group, and group naming policy.